Hello, my friends. I'm International Master AndreasTzermiadianos, and today, in the second part of the video series How to Improve Your Imaginations, we will see another great attacking player. We will see games of Judit Polgar. Hello, my friends. Today we'll see games from a famous attacking player, from Judit Polgar. Polgar was playing in men's tournament right from the beginning. It was a very good choice because he became very strong. Okay, now we'll see two games from Judit Polgar. The first one is with Burgess from Budapest, 2003. B4 was played. And we have the French defense. Knight c3. And black choose to take on e4. Bishop b7. And now there is also the g7 take f6. But this is the most solid variation. Castle and queen d2. Knight d7. Long castle and bishop b7. Okay, we see that as usual. Polgar chose the most aggressive way to play. You can play also with short castle, but this with long castle is very good in this position. And now he came a very new move, a very interesting idea here. Now, usually the plays here like h4 or queen f4 and h4, play this knight g5. Okay, we understand that there is a lot of home preparation when two grandmasters are playing. Okay, so we can, of course, understand that all this was home analysis. But what is the idea of black? Okay, there is some game with h4 here. So after bishop b7, you can play something like check and bishop b7. But this is nothing. Okay, knight f6 is okay for black. The idea of this move to play, this is the real new idea. Bishop h7 check. It's very important to put the king on h8. Okay, because we'll see there are some combinations later on. So after king h8, then to play bishop. Now, the normal idea is to play rook b8. Okay, and white has the initiative with h4. And after bishop a6, Queen f4. Just to notice that knight f6 is not a good move because after knight e5, black has big problems. You can take here, but check, take the queen, you take on d2, and now this intermediate move, and it is clearly better for white. So in this position, Burgess took on g5 because he couldn't fight the refutation. Okay? Can you see how to proceed with white? How to play with white? Black's idea, of course, is easy to understand. If you take on a8, I took a piece and now I take another piece because bishop g5 is coming. So, how to continue with white? There comes an amazing idea from Judit. Okay, in order to open a line, first you have to block the pawn. Not to push g4. So the best idea is this. This is a double threat because white want to open the h-file, but also is threatening to win the rook. You understand this amazing idea, this g4. Black choose to save the rook, but after h4, difficult to survive white's attack. If black take on h4, g5, queen f4, and white queen comes to h4. The positions lose. Okay, bishop g6, king f7. You can try something, but the position's very bad for black. So g6 was played. White took check and bring the queen to f4. Now, the only move not to lose immediately is rook h8. But then white can take on h8, queen take on h8, knight e5. It is not easy because if you protect the Rf7, rook h1, and queen h2 is coming. So if you play, okay, this is a trick, just exchange queens, but also the position is lost. Okay, because everything is hanging, g6, knight c6, and if you take, then the rook can come to d8 or to d7. So in the game, bishop b7 was played, and now a very well-known motif, tactic. Okay, this check, because you cannot, of course, not take the rook, because just double on the h line, f5, something like this, just open all the lines, and it will be an easy mate. So after you take, the idea is we play check with the queen, because if I take with the rook, black can play king g7, but after queen h2, you cannot go to g7 because this intermediate check, and then rook h1. So he goes immediately here, but rook h1, took on g5 with check, and now comes f4. Now, black has to give the queen, take on e4, and in this position, black resigns because there is a lot of threats. Okay, if I take, I just want to play queen g6 or g5, and queen h4, and if you play something like king g7, I can play simply g5, keep the rook to have queen f4, also some ideas with d5, it's very bad position. Okay, an amazing idea in this position. g4, block the pawn, threat the rook, try to open the h line. Let's go to see the second one. Second game was played in Lebanon, in the European Championship 2011. White is the young player from Georgia, Patsulaya, and Judith is playing with black. Okay, I choose to see the position and the game from the black point of view, so to understand the ideas better. Okay, so g4 was played, e6, knight f3, knight c6, g3, d5. Now, he played this strange move, queen c2, because there is no reason to play this move. You can play bishop g2, this pawn, black cannot keep this pawn anyway. So, you can understand that white wants to surprise the opponent. Judith continue with c5, d4, and take. Okay, there is a game now that Judith won against Gelfand in Vikings in 2008 that bishop g2 was played instead of queen c2, and the same plan was played from Judith and e5. Okay, if you go to f3, it's the same because I can play d4, you cannot take the pawn because of this check. So why choose to go to b3? But we see that black is already better here. They have the center, they have no problem, good pieces. White play bishop g2 and now start the initiative. Judith started the initiative with knight b4. We understand that the queen on c2 is a target. And now, very important to understand the move order. Because black wants to play bishop f5 or d takes c4 and bishop f5. But what move to choose first is very important. But I don't think it's so important because Polgar said that here he has to play bishop f5 first, and after knight a3 to take. But because he was afraid that after this move, knight d2 in here, white cannot play knight a3. But I think this is not such a big problem, because even if you go long short castle, black can play this queen c7, a very strong move, a long castle. Okay, it is not good to go to c2, because e4 is coming, and white has a very good initiative here for the exchange. Okay, so I think it's not important because also in this position we'll have the same position after knight. Maybe it's a little bit more accurate to try first. And of course, can you find how to continue? B5. A very good exchange sacrifice. White has to take, of course. And of course, not castle now, because if you castle, bishop h3 is coming. Usual idea. So knight f3, and now it's a very interesting moment because black has a lot of ways to keep the initiative. They can play a6. This was Kasparov's suggestion, a very normal move, keep everything, have the pressure, one pawn for the exchange and the initiative. Also, queen c6 is interesting, but I like very much the way that Judit plays. She chose to sacrifice the knight on d3. And now he's playing with a rook less. Okay? It's an amazing idea because white cannot exchange this bishop on d3. This bishop on d3 is a monster. Okay? He take on b5 because white needs to come to c3 because this check is very annoying. So after this check and knight c3, simply cast, not check because white wants to play bishop e3 anyway. So it's better to just make a cast because now bishop e3 is not a good move. Black has this bishop e4, a very strong move. When you cast it, take on f3, there is not easy salvation to queen h3. Okay? So, what to play? If you play bishop d2, then it's the same problem because I take, I'll take the pawn because queen e4 is coming. Okay? But now knight d5 also. White cannot move anything. You cannot protect c3, you cannot protect e3. So the only move is just to unpin the knight. So rook g1 was played. When you see such strange move, you understand that there is a lot of initiative and attack, a lot of compensation for the material that you sacrificed. Now, of course, check doesn't have any point because white want to play bishop e3 and knight d2. Now knight d2 is coming. So knight e4 is the best idea. Bishop d2. And now, Polgar doesn't analyze a move that is simply winning. Okay, rook d8 is the normal move. But we'll see that the rook does not belong to this file. And also, black cannot play something like knight takes c3 because after this move, check here, there's a very interesting move here. Forced draw. Because why? Black is threatening to play queen b2. If you can go to c1, you are losing. Here there is mate. Okay, so you have to go to e1 and check is a draw, but it's very good that black continues to play. Rook d8 is a very human move, but you will see later that the rook belongs to b8, so maybe immediately this is very strong because I will take on c3 anyway and the b-line will be opened. Now if you go to knight g5 and take on d2 and play simply f6, because the knight will be lost. So if you go rook c1 like in the game, then I have a tempo because I can take and bishop a3. Okay, in the game I was playing rook d8. And now knight g5 is not so good because you can play h6. Now I think black has to sacrifice on f7 and play long castle and be worse. White, sorry. But a very good variation was here noted from Judith. Knight h3 is not a good move. You can take, just take the pawn, bishop e4. Very interesting idea. You want to play queen d5 and mate on d1. So after this move, now the knight will be lost. And the game, of course, because for only four exchanges, it's nothing. Black will be winning. Very interesting to understand that in this position, I put the computer a lot of time in the variation. Even in the moment that he gives the rook, computer thinks that black is slightly better with a rook less. This is very... So, rook d8 was played. Okay. Now, rook c1. The game, white took on c3 and play bishop a3. Now you cannot move, of course, because white wants to take on c3 and play queen e4 to mate, okay? Doesn't want to take the rook. So, bishop e3 was played, take on c1 and rook b8 because the rook belongs to white. Knight d2 is normal move, not to allow rook b1. And queen d5. Now, queen e4 is very good move. Black, he wants to stop queen a5. Okay. Pressure. And a5. Now, black has white has a lot of moves, but black kick. Keeps the initiative in all of them. If you play g4, e4 is and queen e5 is coming. You play queen a3 to control the pawn on c3, also e4 and queen e5 is not easy to move anyway. Black can simply play h6 and there is no easy move for white. Knight f1, queen f3. go back, queen f6. White has a lot of, black has a lot of initiative, e4 or something like that. So queen d1 was played. Now h6 has a trap. Okay, this move creates a trap that white goes into. So the best is something like h4. I'm not sure, because the idea is if you play e4, queen g4, to mobilize the queen, because the queen can come to f4. Tempo. But I can play queen g5 and wait for g4 to play e4 on rook b1. And this a strong initiative for attack. So after h6, queen f3 was played. This is a mistake. White is losing now. And you find how? A very wrong move. Queen sacrifice with me. If you go back, of course, rook a1, take on a2. If you play a3, e4. Now, black has won two tempos in the attack, so the game will be finished. King d1. Now, also queen d7 wins. If you take, you lose the queen. And if queen e8, check, take, and queen f5 win. On the spot, so e4, played, queen f4, and rook a1 to take the pawn and to keep the attack. You see, when you make an attack, you can take some material, take it, and continue to attack. Okay, so queen b8 was played, there is time trouble already. And now there's a very interesting variation, a beautiful variation that Judit show in his analysis. Rook b1. Now, if you take on b1, this is check, you take and mate. If you go to e2, also is the same, check and mate. So g4 was played in the game, queen d7, and it's very interesting. We are in the move number 30 moves were played, and is the first move that black goes back. Is the first move that the black pieces doesn't go to the white king and go back. It's very important to remember, there is in the Russian, I think they said that we Russians, we don't go back. Also, they said this, and I said this to a lot of my students. Piece back, 90% a bad move, 10% an amazing move, never a neutral move. Okay, especially in tactic position. So, queen e5 and the last touch e3. You can play also check and e3, but not to take, of course, the knight, because white has perpetual. Okay, so e3 was played. Now, if you take with the queen, queen a4, knight b3, and take on a2, is winning immediately. And after e3, f takes e3, check, king e1, take, king f2, and take on g1, and white resigns, because after take, queen d1. Okay, so quite an amazing tactical play from Judit, and very interesting